Hello everyone, welcome to Softech. I'm Vikram P. Maduri here. In this session, we are going to discuss about the help you. We're going to do a project on help you. Before starting this session, you should be aware of what exactly is a help you and the definition of help you. I'm not discussing about the definition of help you. You can just go through that in the Google or my previous session. So in the data dictionary, we are going to create a help you and we are going to consume this help you in a search help. And we are going to apply this on a table and we're going to see that. So let's start off and let me explain you about the scenario before starting this. So let's consider a scenario wherein we have two tables, two database tables, employee table. This is an employee table with the fields MPNO, MPNN department. And there is another table with fields EMPNO, salary and currency. Now what we want to do is we want to first create a help view, and this help view will combine the data from these two tables. The fields will be combined from these two tables, and then we are going to maintain a search help in such a way that if we click a drop down, if we click F4 for the employee name, it should get the drop down with fields from all the fields as below. So it should get the fields from the first table and the second table as well. So first let's create a help view, and then we assign search help to the help view, and that help view we are going to assign it to a data element. And this data element is for employee name data element. Employee name. There is a data element for employee name for which we are going to assign this search help. So you should be aware of search help concept as well, and you should also be aware of database view concept as well, which I have discussed in the previous sessions, which you have to go through. Only then you can understand this concept. Okay. Let's move on and discuss that. Let's go ahead with the employee name table. Okay, so in this table, we have EMPNO, EMPNA department. This is the employee table. And then we have the salary table, which has the fields like the second table, which has the salary details. Let's look at that table as well. So this is a salary table, which we already created it. And now let's go and create a help view. So ZJH underscore help underscore salary EMP. So help underscore EMP. Help view is what we are creating. Let's select the help view here, say copy, and then in this we have a sales employee name help view. Now in this we have to go for the ZSAL, the foreign key relation table should be given first and then the value table. Let's go for the relationships, click on the relationships, it will show you the relationship between the any table which is already connected with the foreign key relation will be shown here. So the table that is already connected is ZEMP. Just double click on that and you will get the field names. EMPNO is the common field. Just put the cursor on that. Put the cursor on this and just say OK, copy. And you will get this. And the common fields also will be displayed on the right side. Then directly come to the view fields. In the view fields, by default, the common fields which are there in the two tables will be displayed. Let's go for the table fields and select all the fields that we have here. Like, let's first select from the first table, from the EMP table. We'll select EMP, NA and department. The other fields are already been added. So let's go for the table fields, Z salary. And in the Z salary, we'll go for salary and currency as well. So let's say OK and save it. Let's do the syntax check. I'm clicking on. Okay, there's already a package ZJH Softech. Now in this okay. Now activate this. So once this help view is activated, we have to go ahead and assign this for a search help. So let's go to the help. And here we'll give something like ZJH underscore EMPNA underscore HW, something like that. Create elementary search help. So help you, search help using help you, search help using help you. So in this, we have to go ahead with the view name. Instead of giving the table name here, we'll be giving the view name. And the view name is ZJH star and we'll just see that table name. The view name that we have created just now, let's see that and we'll give that. So the view name is the ZJH_help_EMP. So this is the view that we have. So go for the data dictionary, and in this we'll go ahead with the selection. Say okay. And once it's been done, we'll go ahead with the field names. We'll take all the fields EMP and NBO. We'll take all the fields EMP and NA. Salary, currency, and employee name should be import, and rest of all the fields should be export. So we should get it as an output here. So we'll select all the fields, and the first field 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We just need to save it and activate. So we are maintaining now the search help. So we already created a help you, and then we have used that help you. We have consumed that help you in a search help. Let's activate this search help and let's consume this search help in the data element level. So we'll come back out of it. This is the search help name that we have here. So let's select this, and we'll go. We have the data type, data element name. The data element name that we have is ZJH. EMPNA. Let's check it out. So we have a data element. This is the EMPNA6. This is the data element that we have. Click on change, and here for the further characteristics, here you need to give that search help name, and then we need to give the field name. The field name is EMPNA because we want to maintain it for EMPNA. Save, syntax check, and activate. So once you have assigned the search help to the data element, we can go ahead into the database table and check for the values. So we'll go for display, and in this go for the contents. In the contents you have the EMPNO. Okay, we have maintained it for EMPNA, right? So we'll select it from the EMP table and then go for display contents. In this go ahead with the EMPNA. So for EMPNA, if you click on this, the drop-down has the field names. The help is being retrieved from two tables. The first three fields are coming from the first table, and the last two fields are coming from the second table. In this way, we can make use of help you. So what exactly is the significance of help you? We can create a help you and consume that in a search help, and that search help can be assigned to any of the data elements so that we can get the drop-downs. So we can get the drop-downs from multiple tables. We can do the same thing with two or three tables as well, or multiple any number of tables, but at least two tables is mandatory for the help you to be maintained. If you haven't yet subscribed, do consider subscribing to our channel youtube.com/softech. If you like any of the videos, do share it with others as well. It might help any one of them. And if at all, if you are looking out for any software trainings, you can contact us at our email id training@jsoftech.com. And if you are looking out for jobs, can contact us at jobs@jsoftech.com. Thank you. Have a great day.